Hello everyone, welcome to IMPRINT IS. Today at the IMPRINT Explained, we will discuss the Karvy scam, right? So recently, we have seen that, the Karvy Stock Broking company has kind of done a scam of 1,696 crores. And according to market estimates, it might be a lot more than that. And as a response, Sebi has barred Karvy Stock Broking from taking new clients. All right, so let's look at in detail. This is the article. This is from the Indian Express on 26th of November 2019. And in this article, there's details of how, Karvy, what did they do and what is Karvy. So try to understand for the first time, what is Karvy, right? So they are big stock brokers such as Karvy, right? They are basically finance companies, banks, which offer, online trading on both the NSE and the Bombay Stock Exchange. These brokers have trading platforms that allow their customer to trade in equities, right? They buy paper debts, mutual funds, commodities, currencies, participate in public, etc. Right? And obviously what happens is in some cases, they even give the power of attorney to the broking firm. And securities received in payout against which payment has been made by client should be transferred to the DMAT account of the client within one working day of the payout. And securities kept in the client's unpaid securities amount should either be deferred, transferred to the DMAT account of client upon fulfillment of the client obligation, or should be disposed of in the market within 5 trading days of the payment. So this is the system basically, right? Okay. So, but what happened? On 22nd November, the Securities Exchange Board, SEBI, that is, banned Karvy from taking fresh business, right, for allegedly misappropriating money and securities belonging to its investors, right? And the idea was that obviously that Karvy transferred 1096 crores to its real estate business, and the market estimates say it couldn't be more than that. It can be 2000 crores. Very interestingly, the regulator, that is SEBI, is now learning that there can be similar manipulations from other broking houses also, and this can create a crisis of confidence in the stock market. This is basic idea behind this issue. What exactly? So look at these Twitter handles I picked up. So, he's saying that I'm having my Karvy account 3.5 lakh in equity shares for the past 1 year. Right now, the holdings in DMAT account are different from what he has actually bought. Right. So he said, IOC, I have 22.26 shares, but a DMAT account from my CDSL is showing 21.87. So he inquired it and they informed it's in the pooled account. I asked them to transfer these shares to main and full, and still there has been no action. And without my knowledge, they transferred the share to pool account. So this is a basic scam they're doing. Same way, Arjun GL, there's another. He said, my trading account is with Karvy, payout for 66,000 is pending for the last few days. Really worried for my hard-earned money. So what has Karvy done basically? So if you look into it, what they've done is that they have transferring client shares to itself, pledging shares to raise money, and which is to divert its real estate arm. So in simple ways, what has he done? So it's as if like your friend has a car, right? He has somehow, you have taken his power of attorney, and what you've done is you have pledged it, right, to a bank for a loan, right? So you really don't own that car, but you still have pledged it to a third person, right? So that is what kind of fraud you're doing. Many of Karvy's 2.4 lakh clients have complained to the regulator about money and securities not coming into their trading accounts. Karvy has misused client accounts by without informing them or reporting to the depository or the stock exchange. The KSBL actually had no legal right to create any pledge, right, about this. And obviously this is a misuse of power attorney given right by the clients. To hide its misdeed, KSBL did not report the depository participant account in its submission to the NSE from January to August. And this was only detected during inspection. We come to that. So how much more money was in, involved? Obviously people are still talking about whether how much it would be. Maybe it's the number right now being quoted is 1096 crore. It can be more than 2000 crores, can be even more if other brokerages are involved, right? So how what did the SEBI regulation say? So the SEBI regulation says that the stock broker must segregate his own funds or securities from the client's funds and must not use security or funds of the clients for its own purpose or the purpose of any other client. So this is what the stock broker, SEBI has told basically all the stock broking firms like Karvy. Right, we have already talked about how Karvy does. Basically, they have a trading platform and they, you know, allow you to buy equities, debt papers, mutual funds, etc. Right, and obviously within one working day, if you bought something, it is given to you. If you haven't paid, so this is disposed of in 5 working days. So that is a basic regulatory gaps. Right, so if you notice, SEBI had tightened the relevant portions of 1992 regulations via a circular on June 20th. What they have done said is that you cannot pledge the securities lying with trading members or clearing members to an NBFC or, you know, a bank for raising funds, with even with authorization. So this is became the real problem, right? And when the circular came, you know, basically Karvy tried to do some hodgepodge and try to avoid this. Now Karvy basically, if you think about it, carried out a robbery by breaking laws and norms. And this is basically likened to a promoter of the bank withdrawing depositors' money for personal use, right? So this is something which is very, very problematic in some ways. Remember, even before the June 20th norms, you know, in December 2018, SEBI basically has standardized books of accounts and records in order to make it easy to carry out inspection and compare, right? Brokers were asked for weekly reports for day-wise securities and balances. And obviously, even the international securities identification number and the DP accounts were also inspected. Now, in March 2019, a reconciliation exercise was also done, right? And SEBI directed depositors, that is NSDL and CDSL, to provide pledge details of all brokers, so what has been pledged by them. Now, the question comes, will the investors lose any money? So now, a lot of people say that, you know, maybe, you know, they would not lose anything because there's no default. And the value of the securities is more than the money taken out by the broker. Government sources confirm that money, investors' money will not be lost. Market sources say in case the funds available to Karvy are insufficient, they might get money through the NSDL insurance or from the insurance protection fund. But obviously, IPF cannot be made you know, to make good investors' losses. Why? Because of the fact that even though no securities were taken out and pledged, there was no trace, and IPF money can be only in case a trade has happened. So, you know, that is the thing that they may think this might not happen. But it's still wait and watch whether they lose any money or not, or whether it is just, you know, Karvy just using their money as collateral. And obviously, as long as they're paying up the money to whoever they pledged it to, that is the EMI. So it's not going to be any problem, right? In case you want to understand that, let's think of it that I have taken a loan of, let's say, 10 lakh rupees, right? And what I've done is I have pledged a friend's car for this. Your friend has a Honda City and you have pledged that car for that. Now, for the 10 lakh, obviously, I'm paying an EMI. Let's say I'm paying at 8.1%. So let's say it is something like 800, something like 8,000 or something, right? So 8,000 rupees I'm paying, let's say. Right. So if that's the case, if as long as I'm paying the EMI, it's not going to be a problem, right? The friend's car is not going to go away. But you know, the problem is it's being pledged, so there are going to be issues, right? The friend might not be able to actually sell those shares or sell the car, that is, right? So just to revise, Karvy basically pulled out shares from its clients' demat accounts, transferred those shares to demat accounts closed by them, pledged those shares with banks and took money, transferred the money to real estate arm, failed to return the shares to clients from whose accounts it has pulled the shares from the first place, right? So basically what the NSC said was that Karvy misused powers of attorney given by clients. It sold client securities in the market via entities and the controls used for its own purposes. Now what has happened is Karvy has been banned from taking new clients and execute trades for existing customers. And depositors asked not to act upon instruction on Karvy on the basis of power of attorney. And depositors asked to monitor the movement of securities into the depository participant accounts of Karvy's agent. And moreover, NSC has appointed a forensic audit and SEBI has directed exchange depositories to initiate disciplinary action against Karvy. So that is in summary, right? Now, the broader issues obviously are, there is now calls for stringent surveillance mechanism. This keeps on happening. Karvy, for the matter, has been wrapped on its knuckles many times, even during its IPO in 2014. There's need for structural change in SEBI, right? Something really needs to be done. We have scam after, we have ILFS, then we have DFHL, and so on. modifying the mechanism for posting collaterals and securities and settlements for brokers. This definitely needs to be all these three things. These are broader issues, right? These reforms, structural reforms, need to be done. Thank you so much for listening. Do like or subscribe. If you have any doubts, all right, do ask, right, commenting on this. Join our Telegram group for the PDF of the video.